Hello everyone, so welcome to this session. My name is Beatrice Baldem and I'm owner of Cleaners for Clients, and I also founder of Cleaning Coach Become a Cleaner Plus program. So you're going to talk about training. How can you improve your training process, and how can you do that by understanding for what are you training your staff for? Most people they buy training process and they do themselves training process, but they train the staff. But when they start to send the staff out, something go wrong. Like, they start to get a lot of complaints. When I say complaint, it's not that picky things. Like, some clients, they say, oh, they just miss this thing because they are there with something. Okay, not this kind of thing. Like complaints like, okay, they forget to put the towels on the place. They cleaned the shower, but was some stains, like they rushed it to do it, like they are out of time to do it. So these things, like, you ask yourself, did I train them properly? So what really goes wrong here? So it's because I think you need a training process, but also you need a training method. But before I explain my training method that I just put together with my training process, I'm going to talk about two things I think they are really, really, like, important, especially when you're going to start to just bring staff in. Okay, when you do any transitions to stop working as a private cleaner and you want to just start to build your company. Okay, I know most of people, they just get in cleaning and they just start hire staff and everything. And they have their own, they buy the most, they have everything figured out, to be really honest, is that because maybe they never had experience as a cleaner before, any background in cleaning, but because or they buy a business or they just have the training process and the methods figured out. But for people, they don't have it, and they just start to get out of be a private cleaner to start a cleaning company with staff. I think these two things, they are really important and can really accelerate your training process. Okay. So the first thing is training houses. So when I talk about these, people think, but she had the house and everything is set to just train the cleaners. No. So I think training houses, as I call them, is houses where the cheap clients I have, they don't want to the rate up, or for somehow they cannot pay more. And I not talk about that cheap clients like £8, £10. For example, if they paying £12 for at least like two years, that was before, and I just want to get out of cleaning and I want to bring stuff in. So instead of I tell them, okay, so I'm going to put my rates to £50 or £20. I have trained cleaners, but I want them to get more experience before I send them for a different type of clients. So instead of I just lose them and I really need the cleaners to get experience, I use them as my training houses. I hope it makes sense, but it's a really good thing because if training for 2 weeks is not because the cleaner, they're going to be like experienced cleaner. She had training, but she need to get more experience because she had training for, she's going to still make a few mistakes. But she can do mistakes for clients they pay £12 per hour. But she cannot go and do mistakes the clients they pay £20 or £30 per hour. So it's not like, it's not acceptable. So because that, I just use these training houses for them to get more, gain more experience. It's working for me. And I hope if you are working as a private and you want to do the transition, don't lose these cheap clients. Just use them as your favor, okay? This is my advice. And also, you have your training process. You just need to put your cleaners to get more experience, okay? Before you send them for your high-pay clients. The second thing is, how can you use the skills of your new hires to accelerate the training process, okay? I know most of people, they say, I'm not going to hire someone who have experience in cleaning because they have their own way, so it's going to be really hard to just put on them my training process. It's true, because most of people, sometimes they're working for 2-3 years in that way. I don't say it's wrong what they are doing, but it's not your standard, okay? So because most of people, maybe they just clean, they don't tidy up. They clean, they don't do dishes. So they clean, they don't do laundry or ironing. So because I used to just do cleaning, for some clients, it is amazing because they are paying for that. But you as a company, if you offer all the rest of the service, you want them to get to your standard. But if you want to reset the skills they have before, the training is going to take much more time. And I say this because I had my training process and I start to bring a few cleaners. And okay, but if they have experience, I cannot keep up with my training process. Because I was just reset the skills. Reset the skills. Okay, because this is my 12 steps to clean the bathroom, okay? And they started doing. But at some point, they get frustrated because, okay, they know how to clean, it's true. I just want them to just get to my standards, okay? Because my company don't offer just cleaning, offer as well tidy up or dishes. It depends on the clients, okay? So you have at least like five types of clients. So I need to just them to understand is really different. But instead of reset the skills they have, I just update them to the standard I want for the service I offer to my clients. I think it's really beneficial for everyone, for them and for me and for the client, because I can bring them and just put them to work. They don't need to go along to all my training process. For example, 3 months just training, because I think it takes time to put a cleaner to be experienced. It takes time. It's not just because you clean your house, you're going to clean the other people's house, and you can have a business, it's true. I cannot agree with this, but to have an experienced cleaner is take time to just make her in the kind of thing that she go to any house, any service you send her, and she's gonna do really, really well. Okay, so I think it's time, but because you want to hire someone really, really quickly, and you know that person, she had experience, but she just needs a training to just keep your standards. My advice is, instead of reset the skills, just update them to your level and the things you really want her to just have in place to just go to your clients and just do a really good service. Okay, so now my training method. Okay, so my training method, I use 4 types of cleanings to just add my training process and apply my training method. I hope this makes sense for you, because training process is something you have like a checklist, and you're gonna train them, for example, for the first week to clean the kitchen, just kitchen. They're gonna learn how to clean the kitchen properly. The second week they're gonna go to the bathroom, clean the bathroom. The thing is, sometimes you train them, okay, I'm gonna train the cleaners do on end of tenancy and empty properties. They know how to clean everything really perfectly, so they clean the bathroom. But imagine if your main business is standard cleaning. So they had training in an empty house, okay? And now you send them to a standard cleaning, and it's a house they need to clean around things. It's not because they're not going to make mistakes because they don't know how to clean, but because they're a completely different environment, some of them, they get lost. When I say get lost, for example, they start to say, okay, in there, when I had training, I clean an empty house. So, for example, they take 20 minutes to clean. But now, I'm going to go to the client's house. And I need to clean, but there's a lot of stuff around. So, they need to add 20 minutes more, for example, 10 minutes to just organize things. So, this makes a little confusing to some people. So you need to just be careful when you're going to the environment, you're going to train your staff, and after you're going to send them for a different environment. I know some people, they don't have all these service, or they don't offer all the service I'm going to talk about on my training method. But if you have it, just use them to put your training process and use the training method as well, because I think it's going to be really beneficial. Okay, so let's start for the first place. So first thing when they're gonna do the training process is in Airbnb properties. But why Airbnb properties? First thing, I want them to just pay attention to detail, okay? get ready to pay attention to detail, because Airbnb properties is most about details, really small things. Like, cannot forget the fold the toilet paper, organize the towels, make the beds. Even they cannot leave a small hair. You should not live in any house, but in there is really critical, a small hair in the shower. So they need to really have the attention to detail, and that I like, everything is really perfect, okay? So these I want to have in Airbnb properties. So the second thing is if they are available, because I'm doing this kind of, they have attention to detail, I want to see if they're available as well, because I give them at least 10 hours a week for 1 month in Airbnb properties. Are they available? If they can commit with that 10 hours, to be honest, if they cannot commit with that 10 hours a week, I'm not gonna waste my time with them, to be really honest, to just carry on with the training process. I'm not gonna do it. So at some point in these properties, I can see if they're gonna be something, if they have what I want for my company, okay? So if they not fit that, I'm not carry on with the training, because I can interview them, they're gonna talk, I can go and train them, and after I can send them to my clients, and they start to not show up. Or even there's some people, they do the training and they don't go to the first cleaning, they simply don't show up. So with these, when I start for this, I know I can just cut this, if they are available or not, if they gonna do a really good job or not, okay? So this is okay. So for Airbnb properties, what I want is just see if they have attention to detail, if they are reliable, if they are committed, and how they do my training process, okay? Because I know they need to improve. Some people, they need time to improve, okay? Airbnb properties are for this. The second thing where they go is doing deep clean. So deep clean is in second place, because I want to see how they're gonna work as a team. Because some cleans I need to send like 2 people, even if it's like a standard clean, I need to send 2 people. I want to see how they're gonna work as a team. Okay, I'm gonna keep an eye on my training process as well, if they keep the good standards of cleaning. And also there, I want to see how they react to criticals, because in deep cleanings you always gonna find something people that don't need, because it's deep clean. It's gonna be perfect. It's gonna be perfect, because but you need like a second and sometimes a third eye to just pick up everything as a deep clean, like everything really, 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 really well done. So some of things, like I know they did her best, but I just want to see how they're gonna react to criticals, because imagine you're gonna send them for your clients and they don't react well with you, and after they're gonna start bring on the clients, so no good. If they are the kind of person they don't get well when they get criticals, is also something I think is not good for my company, for the environment. So I just, to be honest, I don't carry on with the training, to be really honest as well. Okay, so the third place they go and the third cleaning they're gonna do is end of tenancy, because there I want to teach them how to clean the oven, how to clean the windows, how to clean the dishwasher, how to clean the washing machine. Because I'm in London and some places, like some houses are studio flats. So sometimes you cannot fit 2 people in there. And even if, for example, if the cleaner is there, if I'm going to hire someone to do the oven, so it's going to be like really complicated. But if I teach them how to do these things, first you're going to bring more money in. And you're just gonna, like, is one person doing one service, okay? And because I teach them how to do these things, I think it's just beneficial for me. And it's better than you hire out, okay? And you not teach them, like, just how to clean, even how to clean and how to clean properly and quickly, okay? So I use this, the third service, for that. And also at this point, I know they are reliable, they are committed, because they still carry on with the Airbnb, they still carry on in doing Airbnb cleanings, and also the standard is good. So when they are doing the Airbnb cleanings, I start to put them doing these things, like, for example, is because Airbnb is 1 month, for in that month they do the Airbnb properties, like, for example, 10 hours a week, and I start to add, for example, 10 hours to do deep clean. the other week more 5 hours to do end of tenancy. So when it's finished that 1 month, they have experience in these three types of cleanings: Airbnb, deep cleaning, end of tenancy. Okay, so and during that month as well, I was find clients for them to just send them, but because my goal is have as much income possible in a regular basis. What I mean for that is just that clients, they gonna hire the service every week or every 2 weeks. Okay, so but I want you to just think about a little in this for this. Just stay with me on this. For example, when you put the ad out, you are looking for what? For a cleaner that have attention to detail, that have experience, that is available. Okay? So if you follow this training method, you can see you just have created a cleaner that you are looking for. Okay? So, and if she get at the end of the 1 month and she have followed all these and she's still with you, she's ready to go for your high paid clients and she was ready to just present your company well. So when you put your training process with a training method, it is really, really great. And you figure out both of them. Okay, you can do your training process or you can buy for someone, because I know out there is really amazing training process, or you can do yourself. It's true. But have a training method as well, not just to train them, to make them to get experience, but also to just cut people. They're not going to be good for a company. And but you're going to think, okay, 1 month is a long time to just train someone. But if you have like deep cleaning schedule, end of tenancy, it's best you send them for that cleanings that they're not going to be alone and you can check on them, then just send them straight away after 2 weeks for your clients, and you start to get complaints. They're going to damage your reputation. Okay, so just try to put both them together, your training process that you did yourself or you buy for someone, and a training method that you're going to go along with your training process. Okay, I hope you can take action, and this information really can help you improve your training process, because I think this is what is missing, is a training method to just get along with your training process, okay? So I need to take everyone to just take time to have this session with me. And I want to thank the ZenMade team, and special to Amar to invite me to just talk about the training and how can you really improve your training process, okay? Thank you so much, everyone.